patients get closer to goal. So if your A1C is 9 and you're pretty high most of the time, then your highs are likely to be a very big mix of mealtime and basal, you know, continuous nighttime highs and such.
Yeah, yeah.
But if your A1C is closer to goal, if you got an A1C of 7.4, you're doing a lot better. Your average is obviously a lot better. It's pretty likely that most of your highs are mealtime.
Yep.
Right? So then we really start putting our focus on getting the meals under better control, changing your food choices, changing the portion size, using medicines that make a difference here, the GLP-1s that make people less hungry, blah, 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 blah.
Okay.
And so we kind of put all that together, and it's a lot of data, but it's data that you go through a relatively similar thing each time, so you get pretty good at it pretty fast.
Got it. tell me about the use of the meters early on. So, you know, it sounds like, you know, pretty much a patient walks out of your office, a diabetic patient, a type 2 patient walks out of your office, and almost every patient's coming away after their first visit with you with a recommendation or a script for a meter, correct?
Yes, I expect just about every type 2 to be checking their blood sugars at least on occasion, yes.
Okay, so tell me a little bit, if we focus on the early patient, whether it's a metformin or you're into sulfonylureas or those types of early medications, so how are you instructing the patients to test, and kind of what is the value that you're seeing from those glucose values at that time?
So if the patient's really early on and they're not on any medicines that have a risk of hypoglycemia associated with it, so they're on metformin alone, maybe they're on an SGLT2, maybe they're on a DPP4, maybe they're on a GLP1 in addition, then I don't ask them to check very often.
Okay.
More checks don't necessarily give you a lot more information. What you're going to look for is trends there. The risk of hypoglycemia is very low, so you're trying to develop kind of good behaviors, good patterns of behavior, things like that. So I'll ask them to check not all that often, really not more often than once a day, or even a little less frequently than that in many cases. But maybe at different times, some checks in the AM, some checks in the PM, some checks at bedtime, and then we'll look at the averages at different time slots and see how things are going. If the person is on medicines that carry a risk of hypoglycemia, so if they're on a sulfonylurea, then you know I have not been seeing this patient a long time because I essentially don't use sulfonylureas. I have patients that certainly come to me on sulfonylureas, and I have patients that have been on them for a while, and so it's a process getting them off of it. I don't take it off in one visit. But my goal in almost all patients is to get them off sulfonylureas. I don't use those very often.
Okay.
I do, though, use other medicines that carry a risk of hypoglycemia. I use insulin.
Yeah.
And so you have to check more often if you're on drugs that carry a risk of hypoglycemia.
Yep.
The more complicated your insulin regimen, the greater risk of hypoglycemia if you're using mealtime insulin and the like. And those patients, I ask them to check quite a bit. Now, you got to check your blood sugars very often. But if you're on a relatively simple, not a huge amount of basal insulin, decent control, you tell me you don't think you have a lot of low blood sugars, we have at least some checks that show that you're not having a lot of low blood sugars, I'll probably slap you on a diagnostic sensors just to prove to me that you're not having a nighttime hypoglycemia that you're not aware of. But I'm not going to make you check a million times a day in that scenario, you know, but we do need to just keep an eye on.
Yeah.
I use the checking there largely to help patients self-titrate their basal insulin.
Yeah.
Your basal insulin dose is not a fixed quantity. It's variable based on what's going on in your life. If you normally eat a certain type of diet, but, you know, you started watching Dr. Phil and he convinced you to eat less carbohydrate or Dr. Oz or whatever, then your blood sugars are going to be better controlled and you don't need so much insulin. You're going to see your readings going down. And it-